الرحیم. السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ. اسٹوڈنٹ ہوپ یو آل آر ڈوئنگ ویل اینڈ ٹیکنگ یور ویڈیو کلاسز ریگولرلی. ایز اسٹوڈنٹ دس از یور انگلش ٹیکسٹ کلاس. ایز یو نو دیٹ وی ہیو کمپلیٹڈ ریڈنگ آف یونٹ نمبر 5 ہیومنزم الانگ ود اٹس ایکسپلینیشن اینڈ وی آر موونگ ٹوورڈز ایکسرسائزز. ایکسرسائز 1 وی ہیو آلریڈی ڈن. اوپن پیج نمبر 91 دیئر از اندر ایکسرسائز, ایکسرسائز نمبر 2. اوکے, have you all opened the book? Now I am reading the statement. What is written here? What are the instruction given here? The exercise 2, the following meanings in the boxes are in the same order as given in the text. However, the words at the top are in a jumbled order. First, underline all the given words in the text. Next, work in pairs and match them with their meanings and write these words in the space provided one has been done as an example. Student, what you will do in this exercise, as you can see here in the box, the words which are given in, which are you have read in paragraph number 1, these words are given in jumbled way, but the meanings are given in order. As you can see, the meanings are given in order. First, what we will do, we will find out the words in the text and then we will match them words with their meanings. یعنی ہم نے, ہمارے پاس جو یہ ورڈس ہیں, پہلے ہم اس کو اپنے پیراگراف نمبر 1 میں انڈرلائن کریں گے اور پھر جو ہے جو یہ میننگس لکھے میں یا آپ کو آرڈر میں ہم لکھتے چل, یہ ورڈس جو ہیں ہم لکھتے جائیں گے اکارڈنگ ٹو دا میننگس. Okay, let's start. Come to paragraph number 1. We have paragraph number 1. You can see the words here. Rehabilitation centers, charitable, humanitarian work, operate. First, we find out these words in the given paragraph. Yes, there is a word, humanitarian. We underline this word. Next word, it was what we have read. It was... the next word given here, humble. It should be underlined. Then another word is single-handedly. Okay, then we have a word in the box, given in the box, charitable. Understand, there is also a word, network, and voluntary, and rehabilitation centers. There is also a word, and drug addicts. Okay, and the last word we have, operate. So these all together are 9 words that are given in the box. When we have already we have underlined all the words, as you can see, first word is humanitarian, humble, single-handedly, charitable, voluntary, network, operate, rehabilitation centers, and drug addicts. تو گرلس ہم نے یہ انڈرلائن کر لیے. اب یہ جو ہے وہ آپ کے پاس جو میننگس دیے ہوئے وہ آپ کے پاس آرڈر میں ہیں, یعنی جیسے جیسے جو ورڈس ہیں, جیسے فرسٹ ورڈ آپ کے پاس ہیومینیٹیرین ہے تو جو آپ کا فرسٹ میننگ ہوگا وہ میچز ود دس ورڈ, دا سیکنڈ میننگ میچ ود دا ود ہمبل اینڈ سو آن. اوکے, آئی کین شو یو ہیئر. اوکے, لیٹس ڈو دس ایکسرسائز. ورک دیٹ ہیلپس ان میکنگ پیپلز لیوز بیٹر. ٹھیک ہے, واٹ از دا میننگ آف دس تھنگ, واٹ از دا میننگ آف دس فریز, کہ ایسا کام جو لوگ کی زندگی کو بہتر بنانے کے لیے کیا جائے. دس ورک از کالڈ دا ہیومینیٹیرین ورک. سو واٹ از دا میننگ, آپ دیکھ سکتے ہیں میں نے آپ سے کہا تھا کہ میننگ جو ہے وہ بالکل جو آپ نے انڈر لائن ورڈس کیے ہیں اسی آرڈر میں ہیں. تو فرسٹ ورڈ اٹ واز ہیومینیٹیرین ورک. سو واٹ آئی ہیو ریٹن ہیئر, آئی ہیو ریٹن دا ورڈ ہیومینیٹیرین ورک. دا سیکنڈ ورڈ وی ہیو لو. واٹ از دا میننگ آف دا لو, اور اس کے یہ کس دا ورڈ دا میننگ میچز ود دا ورڈ ہمبل. سو واٹ از دا ورڈ فار دس ہمبل. اوکے, ان دس وے یو ول ہیو ٹو ڈو آل دس ایکسرسائز. دس از دا وے ٹو سالو دس ایکسرسائز. میں دوبارہ بتا دیتی ہوں کہ آپ کو پیراگراف وائز جو ہیں وہ ورڈس دیے ہوئے ہیں. ورڈس جو ہیں جو باکس میں ہیں, دیز آر ان جمبلڈ وے, ان جمبلڈ آرڈر میں ہیں, بٹ دا میننگز آر ان آرڈر. جب آپ پہلے آپ کو کیا کرنا ہے, فرسٹ آپ کو اپنے پیراگراف میں یہ ورڈس جو ہیں فائنڈ آؤٹ کر کے اس کو انڈر لائن کر لیجیے, اینڈ دین جو فرسٹ ورڈ ہوگا وہ جس جو میننگز جو ہیں وہ کیونکہ آرڈر میں ہیں, تو جو آپ نے فرسٹ ورڈ انڈر لائن کیا ہے اسی طرح آپ اس کے میننگ کے سامنے اس کو لکھتے چلے جائیں گے. سو دس از اے گڈ ایکٹیویٹی فار یو, بیکاز یو ہیو آئی ہیو آلریڈی ایکسپلین یو دا میننگس اینڈ دا چیپٹر, سو اٹ ول بی کوائٹ ایزی فار یو ٹو ڈو دس ایکسرسائز. Okay, student, after doing exercise number 2, we are moving towards exercise number 3, that is on page number 95. And what is exercise number 3? It's quite easy, also quite easy for you. Work in pairs and read the text and fill in information about Abdusattar ED in the following form. ठीक है, आपको एक a sort of form given है जिसमें आपको इनके जो आपने जो अब्दुस्सत्तार ईदी के बारे में पढ़ा है उनकी basic information जो पढ़ी है उनका जो के बारे में जो जो बातें पढ़ी हैं उनका name, like उनके father का name, उनके father's का profession, grandfather's name, reason for grandfather's fame, year of birth, place of birth, title given by people, two services that made him famous, name of first ambulance service, charges for first ambulance service, date of death, place of death and historical honor. So, ये सारे ऐसे points हैं, these are the important points of this lesson. आपको, you can find it easily. आपको नाम लिखना है, what is the name of this person? Obvious that, कि हम किसके बारे में, किस legend के बारे में पढ़ रहे हैं, the name of this personality is Abdusattar ED. And his father name was, it was given in the second paragraph, Haji Abdul Shakur. And what, as you know that, what was his work, unka kya kaam tha? He was actually a dry fruit commission agent. ठीक है, तो in this way you will have to give fill the form by checking out the information in the given text. आप उसमें से check करते जाएगा, you can easily do this. Okay, some information I have filled. I've already filled in the given form, so do it complete, understand? Now we are moving towards exercise number 4. What is exercise number 4? There are 12 paragraphs in the text. Each of the statements given below give the main idea of one paragraph, but they are in a jumbled order. Work in pairs and give each paragraph a number. Then read the text and write the number of the paragraph. If that it represent the first one has been done as an example. अच्छा students, इस exercise में आपको क्या करना है? As you know that the whole text is comprised of 12 paragraphs. आपके पास जो है वो 12 paragraphs हैं इस पूरे text में और हर जो है वो paragraphs के लिए उन्होंने एक कितनी यहाँ पर कितनी statements given हैं आपके पास 12 statements given हैं जो हर paragraph के main idea को represent कर रही हैं. But what is the problem here? They all are in jumbled order. ठीक है, आपको क्या करना है? First you will name the paragraph, give the number to the paragraph, and then read the lines and give the write the number of the paragraph that it represent. आपको उसका number लिखना है जिस जो line जिस paragraph को represent कर रही है. So hopefully you have understood. I'm telling you paragraphs. This is paragraph number 1. Start from here and ends here. Paragraph number 1, it's 2. In this way, you will mark the paragraphs. And as you know that, how many paragraphs are there? There are 12 paragraphs. Okay? Give the number to all paragraphs. Now, what you will do next, you will have to open the exercise and read the first sentence, shaving of Edi's head by his father. Ab ye jo hai, where did you get this idea, this main idea, in which paragraph you get this? So let's find out. Yes, where is it, where it is written here? It is written here, as you can see in the paragraph number 4, he shaved my head. तो यहाँ पर आपको ये पैराग्राफ नंबर 4 में आपको ये वाला मेन आइडिया मिला है. सो दे हैव रिटन हियर व्हाट इज़ द नंबर दे हैव रिटन नंबर 4. ओके, सो व्हाट इज़ द सेकंड सेंटेंस? हिज कमिटमेंट टू एन ऑनेस्ट एंड सिंपल लाइफ. सो वेयर डिड यू गेट इन विच पैराग्राफ? इन पैराग्राफ 11 इज द आइडिया इज गिवन. As you can see, he made a commitment to himself that he would never give anybody reason to challenge his integrity or his lifestyle, and he would never spend extra time or money on himself or for his family. He had only 3 pair of clothes, 1 pair of plastic chappal, 1 jina cap, and he slept on the wooden bench in his dispensary and so on. Okay, so aapka kahan hai ye, where did you get this idea, in which paragraph? Obvious that it is in paragraph number, the second last paragraph, and the paragraph number is 11. So what you are going to write? So I have written here 11 in the second blank. Now the third is Edi's first ambulance service. इसके किस में पैराग्राफ में हमें Edi first ambulance service का पता चला था? So again we are moving towards the text. In which paragraph you can find out? I'm showing you, it is in paragraph in number 9. I have marked the number. This was the first ambulance service for the poor people, and he called it the poor people's van. So this here you can get the main idea. So what you are going to write here, okay, I have written here number 9, it is paragraph number 9. In this way, friend, and you understand hopefully ki cases ko solve to, you are going to solve this exercise. Only you will have to read out the text and read out the main idea, and then find out in which paragraph you will find this main idea. So it's a good activity for you. Now come to exercise number 5. What is exercise number 5? Work in pairs and read the text and complete the following sentences. First discuss them orally and then write them in your notebooks. The first one has been done as an example. Ab ye kya hai isme aapko jo hai wo, it's a sort of a reasoning question. Aapko unki reasoning jo hai wo complete karni hai, suitable reason dene hai according to the sentence, according to the statement. Aapko uski statement ko complete karna hai by giving the suitable reason. Aur ye exercise isme, this what you are going to do, this exercise you will have to do in your notebook. आपको अपनी notebook में भी ये after doing the words meaning, synonym antonyms and sentences, you will copy down this exercise in your notebook. We are doing here in the book. Okay, the first is, they have done as an example. Edie was mainly brought up by his mother because आपको पता है कि Edie को mainly जो है उनकी किसने जो है brought up किया था, किसने उनको परवरिश की थी, who nurtured him. किसने उनको किया था? Because his father main क्यों किया था? Because his father was mostly away from home. क्योंकि उनके father जो थे, इनका काम क्या था? What was his work? He was a dry food commission agent in Bombay. तो वो जो है वो mostly अपने work की वजह से जो है वो outside the city, out of station रहते थे. तो mainly जो है वो उनकी mother ने है उनकी क्या की थी? परवरिश की थी. ठीक है, अब जो है what is the second one? The second one is, in Bandwa, Edie was known as Roti. उनको रोटी क्यों कहा जाता था? Why he is famous among his friends as Roti? क्यों उनको कहा जाता था? What was the reason? Okay, let's find out. On page number 90, you can see कि यहाँ पर आपको जो है, sorry, page number 88 पे आपको मिलेगा कि in the fourth paragraph, his friend, he was known among his friends as Roti. As Edie explained, every time my father came back home from one of his trip, he shaved my hat. तो वो क्या करते थे उनका, जब भी वो whenever he came back from his trip, from his कहते हैं जो भी अपने ट्रिप से वापस आते थे, तो उनका हेड जो है वो क्या करवा दिया करते थे? शेव करवा दिया करते थे. सो दैट्स वाई ही हिज फ्रेंड ऑलवेज कॉल्ड हिम Roti. Okay, so what you are going to write in the given blanks, the reason is, so what you are going to write in the given blank, his father always shaved his head. You can extend the answer as well. कि आप इसमें अपना answer को जो है वो extend कर सकते हैं. Whenever his father came back home from his trip, ये आप ये भी लिख सकते हैं. Because यहाँ पर बहुत ही limited space है, मैंने I have just written the to the point answer मैं आपको दे रही हूँ कि in Bandwa, Edie was known as Roti because his father always shaved his head. So आपको जो है इसी वजह से ये काम जो है वो आपको अपनी नोटबुक में भी करना है ताकि आप प्रॉपरली इसको जो है वो प्रॉपरली आप लिख सकें. नाउ दिस व्हाट इज़ द थर्ड वन, हिज फादर शेव्ड हिज हेड. क्यों करते थे? व्हाई डिड ही डू सो? क्यों उनका ये तरीका था कि उसके हमेशा हेड को शेव करवा दिया करते थे? व्हाट वॉज द रीज़न? अगेन कम टू पेज नंबर 88. द रीज़न गिवन बाय Edie दैट it is simply the most effective way to curb pride and prevent arrogance. ठीक है, ये क्यों था? वो इसलिए करते थे ताकि उनकी जो है उसको curb कर सके, उसको control कर सके, उसको overcome कर सके गुरूर को, और उनकी जो है वो क्या कहते हैं गुरूर और जो तकबर को जो है वो ये control करने का जो है वो बेहतरीन तरीका था. So what will be the answer of this statement? How you are going to complete the statement? What I have written here, he wanted to curb pride and prevent arrogance. ठीक है, मैं यहाँ आप इस तरह भी लिख सकते हैं, because it is the most efficient way, effective way to curb pride and prevent arrogance. There, you can write it differently. It's totally up to you, but the reason must be to relevant. Okay, आपका reason जो है वो क्या होना चाहिए? Relevant होना चाहिए. You can write it in your own way. Understand? So in this way you will do this exercise, read the statement and then write the suitable and relevant reasoning in the given blanks. Okay, okay friend, these are all together 11 statements. Now come to exercise number 6. What is exercise number 6? All the following sentences give wrong information. Read the text and write the correct information in your notebooks. After you have written the correct sentences, discuss your work with your partner. आपको क्या दिया हुआ है ये जो the 10 statements are given here. These all are giving the wrong information. They all are providing the wrong information. You will have to correct them. आपको इसको करेक्ट करना है. आपको राइट इंफॉर्मेशन लिखनी है. और फिर जो है दिस एक्सरसाइज यू विल आल्सो डू इन योर नोटबुक. ओके, तो लेट्स बिगिन. आप अपने फ्रेंड्स से डिस्कस कीजिए, अपने कंपेनियन, अपने क्लासमेट से डिस्कस कीजिए और करेक्ट आंसर लिखिए. फर्स्ट इज ईदी स्टार्टेड हिज ह्यूमैनिटेरियन वर्क इन 1977 बाय एस्टैब्लिशिंग एन एम्बुलेंस सर्विस. अब यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं कि उन्होंने अपना वर्क जो है ह्यूमैनिटेरियन वर्क जो लोगों की मदद के लिए जो काम वेलफेयर वर्क जो स्टार्ट किया था वो किस ईयर में स्टार्ट किया था. आप इसके लिए आपको अगेन यू विल स्विच मूव टू द टेक्स्ट स्विच टू द टेक्स्ट कि आप वहाँ पर ईयर चेक करेंगे. इज इट द राइट ईयर? ये करेक्ट ईयर नहीं है. आई थिंक दिस इज टोटली रॉन्ग. उन्होंने अपना काम कब शुरू किया था? एज यू ऑल नो दैट कि 1977 में नहीं किया था. ही इज बिगैन हिज वर्क इन 1951. ठीक है, मैं पेंसिल से एक्सरसाइज कर रही हूँ. आप इसको करेंगे 1951. ओके, एंड बाय एस्टैब्लिशिंग एन एम्बुलेंस सर्विस. उन्होंने एम्बुलेंस सर्विस पहले वो की थी, स्टार्ट की थी? नो, ही एस्टैब्लिश अ वेरी स्मॉल डिस्पेंसरी इन मीठा दर कराची. आप यहाँ पर क्या लिखेंगे कि यहाँ पर आप एक उन्होंने सबसे पहला जो काम स्टार्ट किया था लोगों की वेलफेयर के लिए, सोशल वेलफेयर के लिए, सोशल वर्क के लिए, वो क्या किया था? ही ओपन अ डिस्पेंसरी इन विच एरिया? इन मीठा दर. So I have written, I have made the correction in the sentence with pencil. ED started his humanitarian work in 1951 by establishing a small dispensary in Meethadar, Karachi. Okay, this is the way. आप इसको क्या करेंगे? पहले आप wrong sentence लिखेंगे and in your copy आप फिर उसका correct sentence जो है, जो correct information के साथ है, वो लिखेंगे. Now come to exercise number 2. What is exercise number 2? Today the ED Foundation has statement number 2. The statement number 2 is what? Today the ED Foundation has less than 300 people working for its small network. So what is the correction here? What is the mistake here? There are only 300 people working in his organization and it is only a small network. No, it's totally wrong. आपका ये चीज़ जो है वो क्या है? गलत है. सो वॉट इज़ द करेक्शन हेयर? वॉट यू आर गोइंग टू मेक हेयर? आप यहाँ पर 300 के बजाय क्या है यहाँ पर? देयर आर, पहले तो आप मोर देन लिखेंगे, लेस चेंज इन टू मोर, एंड 300 चेंज इन टू 7,000 पीपल वर्किंग फॉर इट्स. And there is another correction. What is, instead of writing small, we will have to write huge network. इनका कैसा network था? इनका huge network था, एक बहुत बड़ा network था है जिसमें how many people are working in, there are more than 7,000 people working in this organization. So this is also an interesting and exciting exercise for you people, for the students. आप इसको करिए, read कीजिए और इसमें जो corrections हैं आप उसको correct कीजिए. ठीक है. Okay students, this is all for today. Kindly note down the homework. What is the homework for today? Two exercises, two six in your book. Okay, aapko ye exercises apni book mein karni hai. Hopefully you will do it. Till then, stay home, stay safe. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.